I don't.
Getting ready.
As per usual.
Right. Where are they? Oh, up there.
Up, yeah, up to the right.
Thank you.
Away until after the flower ceremony. So who gives this woman to this man?
We do.
So if you'd like to take photos, now's your chance. Then please put them away again. We are gathered this afternoon to celebrate one of the happiest moments in the lives of Bob and Erica. On behalf of the groom, this beautiful bride, their parents, and their family, I welcome you to their wedding. This marriage is a declaration before God and their family and friends of their unending love for one another and their intent to honor the Lord Jesus Christ in this marriage. Would you join me with Bob and Erica in prayer as we seek God's blessing upon this marriage? Heavenly Father, we thank you so much for this special day. Lord, a day that you etched into eternity from the very beginning. Thank you that you called Bob to yourself, and you called Erica to yourself. And now, Lord, you are joining them together in you. So, Heavenly Father, we ask that you would bless them and their marriage as they pursue not only this special day, but the many days, months, and years that they have ahead of them. In Jesus' precious name. This afternoon, we have gathered to celebrate Bob and Erica's wedding day. We are all here to bless them and to enjoy with them on this very special day. Today is a day we will always be able to look back on and smile. In this wedding ceremony today, Bob and Erica would want to clearly give honor to one person above anyone else, that being the author of marriage, the Lord Jesus. Today, there is a very clear and profound picture that God wants us all to see. Not only will we be able to see the love that Bob and Erica have for one another, but we can also see the the love relationship that God designed each one of us to experience with Him. One of the most exciting purposes of God in creating marriage is so that we can see a natural, physical example of the spiritual closeness and intimacy that He longs to have with each one of us. In one sense, this wedding is a parable of a very real spiritual truth from God. One of the most celebrated events in life is when a man proposes to a woman. There is such an indescribable high in the proposal of marriage. It is a proposal of love, not the surfacey infatuation kind of love, but the kind that is unconditionally committed to each other through every up and down in life that life can throw our way. That is the kind of proposal that Bob made to Erica back on February 20th in that snowy softball field. In the same way, the one and only God who created the heavens and the earth has also proposed to you and me. How? God loves us so much, but He knew that we would choose to turn away from Him and pursue our own desires independent of Him, what the Bible calls sin. God knew that if we were to one day die in that state of rebelliousness toward Him, that we would then be separated from Him for all of eternity. But this is where He took action. God Himself came into our world, became one of us, Jesus, and has proposed marriage, an offer of permanent union with you and me. As a result of His deep and personal love for each of us, He has made an offer of total forgiveness, the opportunity to live forever in a rightly oriented relationship with Him. This is an offer sealed not just with a ring or vows, but His proposal is sealed and made secure with His own blood. Jesus made this possible by taking the responsibility on Himself to bear our sins and pay the death penalty that each one of us deserved by dying for us on the cross. With His own life, He set us free so that we could freely give ourselves to Him. Bob really loves Erica, and he wants to spend the rest of his life with her. In a moment, Bob is going to make a vow to love and care for Erica no matter what, for better or for worse, until death separates them. That is a pretty strong yet sobering commitment. Moments later, Erica will commit herself to Him for the rest of their natural lives. God so deeply loves you and me. His love is an unselfish love, a love that is always patient and kind and always seeks our best and always forgives, a love that is committed no matter what. And best of all, it isn't based upon our behavior. It's eternal. God unconditionally loves us this way through His Son, Jesus. In any proposal, there needs to be a response. Bob initiated with Erica. She was delighted to respond with a resounding yes. But she didn't have to respond to Bob. But if she hadn't, Erica would have missed out on a man who loves her very much and is willing to give up his life for her. In a very similar way, God fervently desires for us to commit ourselves to a forever relationship with Him, but we aren't forced to respond to Jesus' proposal. Think about it, though. Just as Erica chose to respond to Bob by saying, "Yes, I want you to be the most important person in my life, and I give 100% of all that I am to you, and all that I have to you," so each of us must personally, wholeheartedly, and by conscious choice accept Jesus' proposal if we are to have a relationship with Him. So, in one sense, Jesus is down on one knee proposing to each one of us this very afternoon. It's up to you how you respond. Bob and Erica would like all of you to seriously consider the spiritual truth that God intended marriage to reveal when He created it, the intimate and permanent love relationship that He has As we proceed with this wedding ceremony, let us be aware not only of the beautiful uniting of our dear friends Bob and Erica in marriage, but let us also see a picture of what God established as the kind of relationship he desires with each one of us. Let us not only celebrate with Bob and Erica, but be encouraged and drawn to the love of our awesome God. Bob and Erica, all of us are privileged to be here and to celebrate your wedding with you. Marriage is one of God's special gifts to you. The vows you make today are lifetime commitments. You are vowing a lasting commitment, no matter how good or bad it gets, until death separates you. Every person here is a witness to the covenants you will make today in the presence of God, your family, and your friends. Of course, the Bible, and specifically Jesus' life, sets the pattern for how you both are to relate to one another as husband and wife. In Philippians, in particular, we learn that Jesus didn't come to be served, but rather took on the nature of a sacrificial servant. Just think of that. God himself became a man and became a servant. As husband and wife, you have his example to follow. His example of love to follow. That love is a sacrificial love. He valued us ahead of his own comfort, even to his own death. Even so, Bob and Erica, put each other ahead of yourself. That means sacrificing your time, your wishes, and your energies, your very best to each other.
Be imitators of God as beloved children, and walk in love as Christ loved us, and gave himself up for us, a fragrant offering and sacrifice to God. Submit to one another out of reverence for Christ. Wives, submit to your own husbands as the Lord. For the husband is the head of the wife, even as Christ is the head of the church, his body, and is himself its Savior. Now as the church submits to Christ, so also wives should submit in everything to their husbands. Husbands, love their wives as Christ loved the church and gave himself up for her, that he might sanctify her, having cleansed her by the washing of water with the word, so that he might present the church to himself in splendor, without spot or wrinkle or any such thing, that she might be holy and without blemish. In the same way, husbands should love their wives as their own bodies. He who loves his wife loves himself.
Bob, in this section of Ephesians 5, we learn that God's number one command for you as a husband to love. We see a picture of Jesus' love for the church, for his church, as a model for a groom to his bride. In this scripture, there are two key words, just as. The husband loves his wife just as Jesus loved the church. That love is a sacrificial love. Jesus died a grueling death in our place. In verse 25, it explains that he gave himself up for her, his church, his people. He put us ahead of himself in that moment. Even so, Bob, you must put Erica ahead of yourself. Like Jesus, it is important for you to initiate and set an example in the spiritual matters of your new family. Lead it. This can be seen by living a holy and pure lifestyle before Erica and any future children, by seeking the Lord diligently on family matters, and by striving to keep your personal relationship with Jesus fresh, intimate, and exciting. Your love for Erica is an act of your will for the rest of your life. In the presence or absence of romantic feelings, whether you think she deserves it or not, you have chosen Erica over every other woman you have ever met or ever will meet. You will do well to never raise your voice in a harsh way and never belittle, but rather encourage, edify, inspire, and cherish her in your lifestyle together as a couple. Erica, God's number one command for you in that passage as a wife is to love. And to show that love by respecting and supporting Bob first in your life, right behind the Lord Jesus and ahead of your own desires. Love is giving yourself, finding your life by losing it. In doing so, you will be an encourager in times of fruitfulness and in times of disappointment. As you help Bob and any children God may bless you with, strive to new heights of sacrifice and look to God for your satisfaction and fulfillment. Knowing that you are a woman who has tremendous trust in God, you will experience His working in your life as you demonstrate an ability to engage in, discuss, and support the decisions that you and Bob make as a couple. Now, Bob and Erica, I am confident that you both will depend on God to guide you in your marriage as the months and years go by. I realize that you're not perfect, although each of you probably thinks each other's pretty close to it right about now. You'll probably find yourselves making a few mistakes. And when those mistakes occur, recognize them as opportunities to forgive each other, strengthen each other, and look to God together. May the Lord bless you and protect you. May the Lord smile on you and be gracious to you. May the Lord show you His favor and give you His peace. And now, before our awesome and almighty God, let us witness together the start of what the Bible says is a new creation as the two individuals, Bob and Erica, commit their lives to one another and become one. The covenant made between a Christian husband and a wife is done before God, and therefore with God as well as with the spouse. This means that to break trust with your spouse is to break trust with God at the same time. So, what I will ask of each of you next, and your response to it, is meant to represent that part of this wedding covenant that is between you and God. Bob, do you take this woman to be your wedded wife, to live together in the covenant of marriage? Do you promise to love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful to her as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Erica, do you take this man to be your wedded husband, to live together in the covenant of marriage? Do you promise to love him, comfort him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful to him as long as you both shall live? Bob and Erica have also written their own vows to each other and would like to share them with one another now.
I, Bob, take you, Steve, to be my wife, for better and for worse, for richer and for poorer, in sickness and in health. I will cherish and respect you, laugh and cry with you, defend and protect you to the best of my abilities, and lean on God when I cannot. I promise to stay by your side through your successes and your failures, and always give you the benefit of the doubt. I expect you to love the hobbies and passions that are different than mine. I take you with all your faults and your strengths, and as I offer myself to you with all my strengths and my faults. I pray that we can do more to glorify God as we walk through life as partners. I vow to continue to grow with you towards God. I make these promises, loving what I know of you and trusting what I do not. I choose to give you my heart and my faithful love from this day forward for as long as we shall both live.
Now, Bob and Erica will be exchanging tokens as a symbol of their love and commitment to each other. Bob, what token do you give?
A ring.
As a ceaseless reminder of this moment and of the vows you have taken, place this ring on the hand of your bride and repeat after me. I give you this ring. As a symbol of my commitment and responsibility to you, in the presence of these witnesses, in the name of the Father,
the Son,
and the Holy Spirit. As a ceaseless reminder of this moment and of the vows you have taken, place this ring on the hand of your groom and repeat after me. I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my commitment and responsibility to you. In the presence of these witnesses, in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Bob and Erica will now share a private moment worshiping the Lord as they share communion together. Within this act of worship, they are communicating their dependency upon the grace of God for their union to be successful and bring glory to Him. Please pray with me. Father God, thank you so much. We thank you first that Bob and Erica have a relationship with you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Thank you also for bringing them together now in you as one. We do ask for your blessing as they look to you for your strength upon every decision they need to face in life. We commit them in your hands. In Jesus' most precious name, amen. Bob and Erica, since you've consented together in these promises and have symbolized them in the giving and receiving of these rings, by the authority invested in me, I now pronounce you husband and wife. And as the Lord Jesus said, what God has joined together, let no man separate. Bob, you may kiss your bride. Ladies and gentlemen, it's my privilege and pleasure to introduce you all to Mr. and Mrs. Bob and Erica Hindi. On behalf of Bob and Erica, I just want to thank you again for joining with them on this special day. If you just go ahead and stay in your seats, they will return and dismiss you row by row. And after you've been dismissed, if you haven't had a chance to sign the guest book in the back, please take a moment and do so. Thank you. Thank you.
I mean, it's true.
Thank you.